Welcome to This Is My Architecture. I am Han, and today I'm joined by Gabriel from Anchor. Welcome.
Thank you for having us.
Before we get started, tell us a little bit about Anchor.
Yes, of course. Anchor is a ticketing platform. Today, we have more than 40 tenants on the platform. We actually serve tickets for daytime experiences, including, for example, the Statue of Liberty cruises that take you to the island, Niagara Falls, of course, to see the falls in Canada, Alcatraz Island, and we also have some ferry systems like the NYC ferry.
Pretty cool. So let's say I'm one of those tenants on your platform. How do I create an event?
Yes, of course. So, I mean, in the last 6 months, we actually onboarded more than 20 new tenants into the platform. So nowadays, we use a wizard that walks you through the different steps that you have to go through to select the different options that you want as a new tenant, right? So that first, I mean, of course, it's a web application that, you know, the first thing we hit is the CDN. So the CDN, because it's our code, it hits the AppSync, that is our GraphQL gateway, you know? So it goes through here, and then we have some resolvers that basically tell Lambda that it needs to go and fan out to different subroutines, right? So then Lambda sets a bunch of SQS messages that later will get reprocessed by Lambda, right? And then there's an interaction that happens between Lambda and DynamoDB just to finish setting up the whole tenancy.
Gotcha. So how do you enable the multi-tenancy here?
Yes, okay, so DynamoDB, because of the nature of the partitions and everything, we use partition keys for each of the tenants. So we share the same tables, but everything is partitioned by the tenant, yeah.
That's awesome. So let's say I'm a customer. I would like to, say, to go to the Statue of Liberty, or et cetera, right? So how does that work?
Yeah, of course. So we have another of the clients of the system is going to be the customer, right? At the same time, the customer can come from multiple different channels. So we have the omni-channel that is can be you're purchasing from the mobile app or the website or a third-party reseller. When you look up for a Statue of Liberty, you're probably going to find one of the resellers like Expedia, Viator, or Get Your Guide offer, making one of our offerings, right? Trying to sell one of the offerings. So if that's the case, depending on where your channel you're trying to sell, the request is going to first hit the CDN, right, from the client. And then, for example, if it is a reseller, an OTA, they will go through most likely a third-party API that we implemented for us, for them, that is a regular REST endpoint, right? So it will go to API Gateway, and then it's going to hit the same lambdas that the other channels, mobile apps and web websites that we own, are going to go through, right? So if you have a website, for example, if you start your customer journey hitting one of our websites and not going through the OTAs, because we like the whole serverless infrastructure, what we want is just to first show you what is the offering of a ticket, right? Like the description of the event, and you know the some nice pictures and descriptions, etc. So that's all going to be hosted on an S3 bucket, serving as an HTTP server, right? So then it hits the CDN, the CDN returns back that to the client, and the client will be able to browse, go navigate, etc. When it's time to service the dynamic content, then the CDN knows now it's time to hit AppSync, right? So it goes through a GraphQL, it takes a node of the graph, and it processes that using Lambda. We sometimes use also straight Dynamo resolvers, right? That can be later mapped and reused using the pipeline resolvers that are built into AppSync.
Gotcha. So you're capturing the booking experience, but also the experience itself, right?
Yes. Yeah. So when the customer, when it's time to actually board the experience, right, the customer. So the first thing we do is just check them in, right? So check them in, we also have a mobile application that is the check-in application. So they go, we look at the booking or we scan the ticket, et cetera, and it goes through again, right, the same flow. AppSync, Lambda, goes, makes a dance with DynamoDB, and SQS puts some messages that will be processed later, right? Customer service, post experience, or anything that needs to happen after the check-in process, it puts a message in SQS and then later gets processed by Lambda.
Gotcha. Mm-hmm. So they're able to do the booking and also capture the experience and mm-hmm. also potentially get a feedback
yes.
from
yes.
The property?
Yes, of course. Yes, yes, yes. So after the check-in, right, we put messages in SQS, and later an email gets sent to the customer so they can reply back and, you know, remind them to go and write a review on the experience.
Awesome. Well, that's a really awesome architecture at scale. So thank you so much for sharing.
Thank you.
And thank you for watching This Is My Architecture.